Hi, welcome to the Certifications Kits presentation on how to pass your CCENT or CCNA exam. So you may be asking yourself, where do I start and what items do I need to have available to me to help me pass my exam on my first attempt? Well, what we suggest for you to have are these six items available to your study arsenal, and you will have an excellent chance of passing the exam on your first try. So let's take a look at these six items at a real high level, and then we'll go into more detail on the following slides. The first thing will be your CCENT or CCNA study guide, and this will be a full-blown study guide. We're also going to complement that with some sort of in-depth subnetting study guide. The next item is to have a CCNA home lab. This way you can actually get your hands-on experience. And you're going to need some sort of lab workbook to complement your lab. The next item is Instructor Led CBT or computer-based training. These have come down tremendously in price over the past couple years, so they're very affordable now. And finally, you're going to need some sort of test engine or exam simulator to gauge where you're at and if you're actually ready to go and sit for your exam. Okay, so on to the next slide, the CCNA study guide. All these study guides that we have listed here, they're all great choices. You can't go wrong with any of them. So, the first one we have is actually an online resource. If you go to the website freeccnastudyguide.com, you'll see it. Not only is the CCNA study guide there, there's an ICND-1, there's an ICND-2, and it's at the perfect price. It's free. It's easy to read, has lots of analogies, it has lots of detail, so it's good for newbies, good for old pros, good all-around product, and it's free. That's the best part. The next item from Chris Bryant at the Bryant Advantage. Chris, he's a CCIE, he's been doing this for a long time, has lots of great articles and videos, informative for all levels of Cisco candidates, lots of good reviews on his stuff, so you can find that at thebryantadvantage.com. Our next option for a CCNA study guide is it's published actually by Cisco Press, and the author's Wendell Odom. His books are very, very detailed, great information. Sometimes it's a little bit hard for some of our students that have no real networking background or experience to comprehend some of the concepts because he goes so in depth. But on the flip side of that, generally the people that are students of ours that do have a Cisco background eat his stuff up because he just brings it to the next level how much detail he covers in his book. And the final solution we have there is the Cybex book by Todd, well-known book. It's very easy to read for the newbie with lots of analogies. Sometimes it's not as in-depth enough for the old pros. That's probably the only complaint that we've heard on that. But all these books are great. And, a lot of our students use a combination of two or three of these. So you may say, you like how one author writes, but you didn't understand one topic here or there, and then you'll see how another author presents it, and then it really sinks in when you have two different viewpoints to look at it from. Okay, so the next item here we have our in-depth subnetting guide. We have two resources here, and the first thing you might be asking is like, well, I've looked at some study guides and subnetting's covered in a study guide. Yeah, you have a 600-page study guide there, and they cover maybe 10, 15 pages at most generally in subnetting. You need to know subnetting inside and out. Otherwise, you're not going to pass the exam. If you are at all intimidated by variable length subnet mass, you're not ready for the exam, don't take it. These two resources will really help cement the concepts into your head, and you will be confident when you walk into the exam room that subnetting is not going to be a problem for you. So the Bryant Advantage, they have a Mastering Binary Math and Subnetting resource. It's over 100 exercises, excellent resource. And here at Certification Kits, we have the How and Why We Subnet workbook, over 100 pages, over 100 exercises, so you could just see how much more detail there is there than just your overall CCNA study guide. So that's why we recommend really hitting the books on variable length subnetting, and these are both excellent resources. Can't go wrong with either. Okay, now here's the fun part of studying, where you actually get to have your hands on some Cisco routers and switches and play with them, break them, fix them, and all that good stuff. What we suggest is a three router, three switch kit is preferred. I'm going to go over some suggestions here really quickly, because we have a video for 15 minutes just talking about building a lab. But you can see at the bottom of this slide here, we have, if you go to certificationkits.com, Cisco-labs-suggestions, you could review that article there. Tons of good info. Now, the key is getting the right mix of equipment. A single type of router, having three of them is not always the best. Depending upon budget, there's lots of different ways we could compose a serviceable lab for you. But you want to try to get at least one router with a fast Ethernet interface for your inner VLAN routing, trunking, things along those lines. One router with two serial ports so you can do your frame relay labs. A router with dual Ethernet or fast Ethernet interfaces for your NAT-PAT labs. And then something nice to have, even on a new version of the exam, is iOS 15, such as an 1841 256 64 router. Something just to watch out, the 128.32 can't support iOS 15, so if that's something you really want, make sure you have the right memory config there. But it's a nice to have, not absolutely required. You do want to have a minimum of 2950 switches, no 1900, like 1912s, 24s, no 2912s, 24s, things along those lines. What is a nice to have is to have a 3550 or 3560 layer 3 switch in there. So you may be saying, hey, what do you mean by that? Well, you'll find out switches generally operate at layer 2, routers at layer 3. The 3550 and 3560 switches operating it, which can operate at layer 3, they can route. So it's a really cool concept, not hit really hard on the CCNA exam, definitely on CCNP, but it's nice to get the exposure at the CCNA level. Another nice thing to have is a rack to make things nice and neat. You have a sweet little rack like this in the bottom right hand corner, and this fits right underneath the desk. It's less than 30 inches, so it could fit under a desk, fit on a desk, or we even have ones that are on wheels, or, you know, full-blown racks. Also, don't forget a USB to serial converter if you don't have a 9-pin serial port on the back of your computer. Sometimes people aren't aware of that, and they get a little bit upset if they don't have the ability to be working day one because they're missing their USB to serial converter. So again, you could review the URL at the bottom to get more in-depth information on our lab suggestions. Okay, so the next item you need in your study arsenal is a real lab workbook. You might say, well, you know, I've looked in some of the study guides, there's some labs in there. Yeah, they do have some labs. You probably have a total of about 20 pages of lab scenarios in your CCNA study guide. And they generally have a lab, something along the lines of what you see at the bottom left-hand side here, just basic lab. You'll have two routers and a WAN link. Not very complicated at all. You're probably not going to work at a company with only two routers and a WAN link. And if you do, you're probably not getting paid very much. So what we really suggest is to have a full-blown lab workbook like the one that we offer. It's 450 pages. It has 60 different complex labs. We also have review questions and answers at the end of each of the labs. You can see all the topics that are covered at certificationkits.com/Cisco-CCNA-lab-workbook. Don't forget the trailing slash. And here's a sample of a lab topology editor workbook. You see your dual WAN links here, so you can do your load balancing, you can set, you know, different costs on the various links. Each of these routers, they have dual fast Ethernet ports. So we have multiple LAN segments here, going from R1 to R2, R2 to R3, then to each of these computers. So obviously this is a much more complex scenario, and by really being able to see how all this ties together in a lab, it helps cement the concepts and the topics that you're going to see on the exam, and that's really for your exam success. Okay, so the next thing we have here is instructor led CBT, computer based training. You could see a whole CCNA class for a really cheap price instead of spending $3,000 going to an on site one. All these are excellent instructors. Pick your favorite, any of them will do well. Chris Bryant could be found at Udemy.com. It's a streaming solution, and after the coupon, we've seen online it's generally about $44. Jeremy at CBT Nuggets, another well-known instructor. Their solution is a streaming solution also. It's $99 a month. It's more of a subscription-based. Great videos there too. And here at Certification Kits, we have Pat Conlon. Pat's a double CCIE. He's done hundreds of classes. He's written CCNP books, CCNA books. And you can find it at certificationkits.com. You can add it to one of your kits. And of course, it's a physical DVD we sent to you, so there's no streaming. And generally, when you buy it with a kit, it's about $50. Okay, so the next thing that you're going to need is your test engine or exam simulator. And we have test engines that are at every price point. Pick one that fits your needs. We're going to cover four of them here. Transcender, you really can't go wrong with Transcender. They have really great explanations. They have a pass guarantee. They're the priciest of the bunch, though. They're $235. The next one we have is Measure Up. Currently, they're only offering the ICND1 exam. I'm sure they'll come up with the ICND2 and CCNA shortly. We're in November 2013 right now, so the new version of the exam was just released, but there's generally run around $99. Boson, $119 for their CCNA exam, gives Transcender a run for their money. Another good test engine exam simulator. Again, you just have to look at your different price points. Certification kits, we have one also. We include it w free with purchase of any kit. If you want to purchase it separately, it's $29. Okay, so now you have all the pieces for your study arsenal. So now what? Generally, what we suggest you do is to take your study guide, your CBT, and you read, watch the first three or four chapters because that's generally your theory, some of the subnetting. Complete that, then go into the Subnetting Workbook, complete those exercises, and once you're done that, you're ready to start the meat and potatoes of the CCNA or CCENT exam topics. And what you're going to do is you're going to start to match up the lab exercises in the lab workbook to the study topic you just reviewed and watched. So if it is EIGRP, you just read the chapter on that. Do the corresponding lab and you keep going from there. OSPF after that, switching, yada yada yada. So, after you complete the books and the video, you take one of the exams. These exam test engines have multiple test banks. Don't take them all at one time because you don't want to memorize them. So, you take one, print out all the questions you got wrong. Hopefully you scored 85 or better and you might be ready for the exam. But if you didn't, print out the ones you got wrong and go back and review those topics. Do the labs over. Once you are done all those, then you go and take the second exam. See how you do there. Keep doing this until you're scoring a solid 85% and you know it's not from memorization. If you follow those simple steps, you have a high probability of passing your exam on your first attempt. Okay, so you're ready for the exam. What are our exam day tips? We like to schedule the exam for about 11 a.m. This way, if we get up late, if there's traffic, we're not rushed. The guys who work for me, we usually give them a half day off or what have you, so they could prepare. They're not stressed out. And it accounts for any unforeseen instant issues that come up first thing in the morning. Make sure you get a good night's sleep the night before your exam. You don't want to be battling a hangover in addition to Cisco's trick questions. Would not be a good combination. make sure you know how to get to the test center. Many times I hear students say they missed their test time because they could not find a test center. This should never happen. Give yourself plenty of time to get to the test center. Try to arrive an hour early. This will allow you time to compose yourself for the exam, review any last minute topics you want to brush up on, and also gives you a buffer again in case of any traffic issues, your car breaks down, you get lost, what have you. Once you're there, relax. Review your exam, your cram sheet, your notes while you're waiting for your exam time. You know the stuff, you just need to read your questions carefully and answer them to the best of your ability. Never leave a question blank, as if you do, it's automatically wrong. Now, let me just back up for a second here. First thing you want to do when you sit down and before you actually start your exam, you're going to get these little laminate charts. Write anything you think you might forget. Write it down on a chart. Write down your subnetting chart. So you have your power of two or what have you for subnetting. If there's a specific command you think you might forget, jot it down on this. Then start the timer on your exam. Read the questions carefully. Cisco likes to try to confuse you and trip you up on that. So just read the questions carefully and use process of elimination if you don't know. So usually there's one or two answers you could just throw out, and if you could get it down to just between one or two, you could usually make an educated guess. You do not have the option on this exam to mark a question for review and go back to it. Be aware of that. So you have to answer it and then just move forward. And again, answer them all, because if you leave any blank, you definitely got it wrong. Okay, so that about sums it up. I think if you follow these simple suggestions we gave you, you'll have an excellent chance at passing your Cisco certification exam on your first attempt. And we wish you the best of luck. If you have any questions, feel free to go to our website, certificationkits.com, use the contact us button, and shoot us an email. We'll be happy to help you.